I know it doesn't look like it, but this world is completely filled with glaciers. There's a lot of green and yellow here, but I promise it's all glaciers. Every single tile is going to have this little picture of glaciers. And glaciers are terrible. I guess you get more supply limit, but basically this world is going to double as in, like, what if no one could colonize ever? Because there's gonna be like no colonization. At least not, I mean, who colonizes glaciers, am I right?
I'm looking at you people that colonize Antarctica.
I'm like unsure if the game looks weird because of all the glaciers. Is this normal? Glaciers in the sand, in the desert? That doesn't seem right. Again, every single bit of land has been turned into this. So there's also this Arctic modifier and mild winter, which can become severe at any point. Basically, there's like no supply limit for anyone to move here. A lot of attrition for enemies. This is gonna be like the defensive world. This is like the turtle world. Don't expand your empire, just hold on to everything. I kid you not when I say this is like one of the worst EU4 games I've ever seen. I'm serious. Now, I don't expect too much to happen. This should be a kind of a normal game at first because that's not a whole lot of expanding going on. We gotta see if Ming doesn't expand. No expand dong for Ming. There's no colonization because, like, the entire new world, there's no point to colonizing it with all the glaciers out here. I'm pretty sure the Europeans are gonna be really weak in this game. They can't, like, do anything. There's no place for them to go get power from. England's not even worried about France in this game. They're just going straight after Ireland. Potato man funny. Others won't be able to colonize either, and because EU4 exists in this weird alternative history, the Mamluks love... Wait, obviously it exists in weird alternative history. Because EU4 loves to let the Egyptians colonize Australia, that's not gonna happen either. This is the one time the mummies will not get to the upside down universe. Tombs will have to stay in the pyramids or their own desert, I guess. I don't know. It makes sense. It did make sense. Wait, what am I talking about? There's glaciers everywhere. There's no desert.
Bruh.
Castile already has Aragon, and Aragon still holds on to Naples at the moment. Naples already moving up the Italian peninsula. Let's get an early Italy going. Wait, I've never seen these guys before. That's interesting. Portugal's already down here. So Portugal and Castile still going after the Moroccans. Again, as always, Denmark has been drinking, and I don't know how they made it up here. Someone should have took their keys. I just kind of hope that with, like I said, the Europeans are not going to get here. No one is going to get here. So I'm hoping the natives have the most epic game. Pretty sure the Incans should form. Maybe the Aztec Empire can rise up. Are we going to see like a reverse? Are we going to do that sunset invasion? How is Russia already a thing? They must have barely hit the requirements. I thought they have to take more of Kazan. Oh boy, the Ottomans are already up here, north of the Black Sea. All the Mamluks are taking out the Ottomans. But there's this nation, surprised that they're still around. Who is that? It looks like a crackhead Korea.
Bruh.
Moria! Damn, France! All right, France is not gonna allow Castile to get too powerful, apparently. Also, the Pope slapped Naples back. What happened to Korea? Hold up! Korea's no longer here. And we got something in Europe called Moria. For reals, though, who is selling crack? Is it the British again? Are you over here with opium? Gave it to Korea instead. Russia's already going around all the hordes. They don't care about the hordes. They're not gonna care. So yeah, just to remind everyone, it is the 17th century and nothing is happening here. The most is they got to these glacier islands. Portugal got to these glacier islands and said, you know, F it. We ain't colonizing anymore. Dang, Venice. Oh man, look at this thick Venice. And they've got a little piece here since the Ottomans are struggling. I don't know if that's good news for them. How is Aragon in North Africa? Well, I guess because Castile is struggling. Oh, you know what? Aragon's probably not a puppet anymore. Oh boy. Oh no. Oh, Denmark, don't do it. Denmark. Come on, well, you know, at least they got their life together, because clearly they went to AA meetings, they figured it all out. Wait, what? All right, Scandinavia now, Scandinavia. All right, was Scandinavia gonna be able to hold back this big old Russia? Actually, this is not a very powerful Russia, but they're just deciding to colonize for some reason. Yo, what has happened to Korea? This is kind of sad. I've never seen Korea fall like this. Japan's unified though. Oh wait, Korea's still here, huh? Yep, they just have, is this Busan? That's Joji. Again, there's also nothing in Africa, so the Europeans, I mean, they'll take things over. Actually, yeah, not really. France is just here, next to Morocco, and that's it. Yo, the Aztecs are having a great time over here, though. Coco Melon? Do they have a YouTube channel? Oh, and I think the Inca are gonna form, too. But I don't think the Inca or any of the natives will go more. Well, I don't know. They out here moving around, though, a lot. Please reverse, Cardus. Oh, Scotland! It's kind of amazing Scotland's still alive. The Isles took over Scotland. Also, Burgundy is still here for some reason. France hasn't decided to eliminate Burgundy. Thick Hungary, thick boy Hungary. And thick Venice, look at Venice. Venice kind of sprinkling in the territory here. Ottomans completely fallen apart. Theodoro also, so Russia probably played a little bit of a role with that. We're gonna see just how good buddies Poland and Hungary are, because apparently they're besties, but in this world, I don't know, things might get tense. Bros before, I shouldn't. Is that Ming? Why is Ming in the Philippines? Why are they're the only people that have colonized at all in this world? Well, at least in the last 200 years. Again, I think these countries like colonize once and then they realize, wow, it's all glaciers. It always has, and then they just, no. So Lithuania is still under Poland. That should keep Poland safe from Hungary? Are they friends? They're not friends. Hungary is friends with France, Naples, and the Pope. Uh-oh. England is a junior partner to Austria, and Austria is currently being wrecked right now. This is all Austria is. This is all, they're not thick. They're actually like grossly thin and slimy. I don't know why they gotta be slimy. I guess they're slimy because they're being occupied by Venice. I love this Venice. So let's keep up those like, archipelago type nations though. I always get depressed when they leave us. Why are the Timmies still here? The Timmies are looking kind of good. They're actually eating up the hordes more than Russia is. Okay, Ming has two spots now in Japan. I don't know how they got these two spots. While this new Korea is here. Wait, is Crackhead Korea gone? Crackhead Korea is not gone. All right, good. Dude, there's gonna be so many Greeks that are mad about this Crackhead Korea. Mine's Moria. The most insane thing is that Ming hasn't exploded, so I'm pretty sure they're gonna win. Serbia, please. I need you to calm down, Serbia. Watch Serbians, please. Just make sure. Actually, you know what? Oh, they're gone. Never mind. Doesn't matter. I'm not even going to finish what I was going to say because it probably would have been bad. Atri is still not getting any better, but you know it's going to be collapsing at some point. France is already getting their little fingers in there, crawling it in, putting it in the potato salad. I like how Sub-Saharan Africa is looking pretty good, although they need to watch out for the Mamluks. Since the Mamluks can't colonize Australia, they're taking it out on the world. They're like pissed. Persia and Timurids are here. I'm not used to seeing both of them. I feel like one collapses, the other one pops up out of the ashes. Fairly certain Russia's maybe the strongest, but then again, I know Ming is good. Oh my goodness, Ming! Okay, yeah, Russia might be the only thing that could stop Ming at this point. Also, how did Japan get involved? Why is Japan in the Chinese Empire? Something horribly, horribly bad happened. Oh yeah, what is this? Wait, Korea's here too! This other Korea! Who are you? Is this even Korea, actually? Oh, the Inca have formed! Inca and South... Wait, who the hell is... What's going on right here? Why are they all together like this? They're all huddling together. It's probably so cold out there. They've got to huddle together for warmth. These hundreds of natives. Oh, they're actually fighting. Never mind. They got together just to destroy each other. Well, you guys got to be working together. Also, is the Choctaw the strongest native? I think this world could have happened if, like, the Earth moved far enough away from the sun, right? Just a couple miles, a couple hundred miles. Whoa, Poland! Now I know Poland's trying to head north, but you don't have to head north to go to space, Poland. Just, you know, go up, not north, whatever. You make it to space however you want. How is France? Okay, again, we've got a lot of drunk countries, clearly. We've got France and southern Sweden and in Denmark. I like how Holland's kind of casually been here. Actually, no, I like how Burgundy has casually been here the whole time. France hasn't destroyed. Why is France letting this happen? Also a little bit of Reconquista from Morocco. Aragon still holds Algeria. Aragonese Algeria. Greatest name ever. Venice, this is getting so weird. Venice has gotten like southern Naples. They took out Crackhead Korea and they have still a lot of former Turkish lands. I'm sorry, I shouldn't call them. Hey, these nations are kind of colonizing, right? I don't remember this, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure. Ming still has their foothold in Japan. So does Korea. And, oh, Ming's up here too. Ming, what's going on? Scandinavia, former Danish land, has been pushed way back. At least they're still alive. They still have Iceland too. Scottish Britain. That's, why'd they rename themselves? What happened to the Isles? I don't see a Flanders. Holland's still there though. Dang, the natives haven't really done a whole lot. Except this guy decided, you know what? I don't want to be, he went back. They're still, that's beautiful. Huddling for warmth and for fighting in the glaciers. Very romantic. Kilwall still doing their thing. Kilwall doesn't mind colonizing. So you can colonize, you just can't colonize overseas for some reason with all these glaciers. Nothing in Australia, nothing in Oceania at all. Manchu has somehow, is this a nation that was formed or something? It must've been formed, right? They also kicked Ming out of southern Japan. Ming still has northern Japan. Austria, please. Okay, so clearly Austria lost their personal union over England, but now they're doing something to Scotland. Poland, please. Okay, Poland kicked out Scandinavia. Now Iceland is free. They don't know exactly how to get to space, but they're gonna find out. They're gonna find somehow. Man, they've been buddy-buddy this whole time. Hungary and Poland really are like homies. They're ride or die. Venice, still alive, but they have lost a lot of stuff to the Mamluks. Also, France is doing their thing. They're still out here imperializing. They're not colonizing. Glaciers stop colonization, but they don't stop imperialization. That's what we've learned today. I'm not kidding. It's 1850. The year is 1850. This is it. Like, we're just out here. We're just fighting in the Eastern Hemisphere. How are they getting over here? We also have Russia in Taiwan. Why? Russia? Oh, Russia's doing some damage, though. I think Russia's gonna slowly take out Ming. India still hasn't unified, so there probably is no one else that can stop Russia if they take out China. Nipples? Nipples, Tibet? What's that? Wow, is Scotland slowly gonna be consumed? Yo, we need those Scottish warriors to come back. The Highlanders. Why is Poland and Russia being so chill, though? That's the real question. I guess Russia's been so occupied with everything everything in the east. They don't care about Europe. Wow, that is such a weird... That's very cursed. Austrian Britain. Okay. And they're just gonna allow that too? Who is that? Burgundy! Why is Burgundy in southern Portugal now? Burgundy still exists here. I like that Switzerland still exists too. I mean, the New World was completely covered in glaciers. Portugal can't colonize. And then what's their point of living anymore? They just decided to off themselves. Yo, the Inca are still united, but the Aztecs aren't anymore. I don't know what happened to the Aztecs. You go, Persia. You go. You... Yeah. Do it. Wow, look at this smashed wide Timurids, let's go. We see Timmy so often as long, but never wide. That's his next evolved form. All the world needs to do is have like a union between Poland and Hungary, and that'd probably end this whole game. I think that would be it. I know Russia looks thick, but this would be more development, something. Ming is still alive, but it's so sad. It's very sad, Ming. Surprised that Japan is still around. Japan is now the new Korea. We've got northern Japan and southern Japan. I have a feeling I like the north. Yo, Hungary's kicking out the Mamluks now. And, you know, the Mamluks are struggling probably against France, too. Oh, Persia's coming, too! Dang, fall of the Egyptians. They really needed this. They really needed it. Hey, Delhi's starting to form a little bit in India. Probably a little too late. Timurid India. Dang, look at these guys. These guys ended up getting a lot of these. They were going to get to Australia. They would have gotten to Australia before the Europeans. I thought that was Spain for a second. Nope, that is Vajigar. Oh, the Aztecs ended up unifying, kind of. Who won? Top 8. Manchu. Persia, Hungary. Hungary's in 6? They look better than that. Pasai, Poland, Delhi, France. Russia number 1, of course. Dang. France was a lot more powerful than I thought. Poland and Hungary were weaker than I thought. They needed a union. They needed that. All we have to do to make this become a reality is maybe for like the Earth to get bumped off course a little bit. Have the next like apocalypse, have like a post-apocalypse. Rise to the top again through the medieval ages, the Renaissance. And basically this could play out exactly the same way. Yeah, these other map modes are gonna look weird because nothing really... Wow, no Protestant Reformation. What happened to Protestantism? Nothing. Culture didn't change. That's so weird to see culture not change. It's still all native culture here. I like that Venice and Genoa ended up surviving though. They don't look as great as they once did, but not bad.
And big thanks to Douchebaggins.
Popcorn 2008.
Garland, Land of
Julius
Gar.
Cheeser.
Can't think of a name.
Prime Minister Zeffy.
Peyton.
Fusion
Drew,
Wolf.
This is your dad. I am leaving you.
Manny Manny 74.
My
Deezer 123. Every time communism
Mac.
Has been tried,
Rats
it
Mac
has failed.
Aryan After
Pan,
Hours,
Qualavs,
Luxembourg,
Stub,
Scarlet King,
Mayonnaise Incorporated,
Hipster
Lama, Warren Like
Maxi
Stalling,
G, Alphonso
Elias,
San LCC.
Senpai.